going to do my presentation in English, but if anyone has a question and if they want to chat in Turkish after this presentation, we'll be here. Hello, everyone. It's great to be joining you today at this amazing event. There's so many brilliant minds at this Cosmoverse, and it's been truly inspiring to be a part of the Cosmos ecosystem. I'm excited to chat with you today about some industry trends we're seeing at Circle, and the tools developers can utilize to build a Web3 project powered by Circle. I'm Cem, Ecosystem Growth Director at Circle. Our team's focus is growing our builders and startups and developer ecosystem. We identify and incentivize early stage projects, builders, developers, building on Circle's products, protocols, and solutions. After that, we build internal and external operational capabilities and programs to help create a full life cycle of incubation to innovation and funding programs. So an interested developer like you could go from a hackathon participant to being funded by our grant program, to building projects in a Circle ecosystem, or get investments from VCs. To most of society outside of this industry, and definitely outside of this room, blockchain technology is still not too clear, maybe a little scammy and opaque. But this is where we come in. Trends are showing that soon in the near future, those who don't adopt blockchain and its rapidly advancing protocols will be left behind. Despite headwinds, consumers have demonstrated a strong and growing desire to transact with digital assets. Crypto transaction volume has grown more than 4x in the past 2 years. And by 2027, 10% of the whole GDP could flow through blockchain-enabled transactions. And in total, while the blockchain market is estimated to be around $10 billion today, it's projected to grow to $100 billion by 2027. So it might be a cliche, but we have only just scratched the surface in adoption. We can all agree that blockchain solves important problems for everyday user and spans a broad use cases beyond just speculative trading. A few of the very obvious benefits are, first, cost. Blockchains unlock transactions for global users who were previously limited by cost. Transactions now are a fraction of the cost of legacy payments like wire, and not to mention the headache of foreign exchange fees, which can seriously damage and break down the global trade and commerce. The second thing is security and accountability. The security of on-chain transactions are unrivaled. With data sharing being near instantaneous and fully traceable on an immutable ledger, and also additionally with key sharing protocols like MPC, decentralized identity offerings, bad actors are weakened as transparency and security are magnified. It also helps with the automation, right? Programmable smart contracts have changed the game for automating payment and business workflows. Users can easily create and manage automation specific to their business and their business needs. It also dramatically improves the speed. Global transactions are becoming as easy as fast as sending an email. Understandably, it's going to take time for global users to pivot operations and adopt new infrastructure. But as we've done hundreds of customer interviews and hours of research, we are finding that there are several blockers or challenges to new user adoption that we must consider. I'm not going to go through all of them, but a few of the most glaring ones is, first, the technical complexity. Web3 technologies such as blockchain, smart contracts, and decentralized networks can be complex and require specialized knowledge and expertise. Integrating Web3 into existing systems and processes can also be challenging, and particularly for businesses without prior experience or dedicated resources in this arena. Also, regulation. This is one of the biggest challenges right now. The regulatory landscape surrounding Web3 technologies is still evolving globally, which can create uncertainty for some businesses. Compliance with existing regulations, particularly in industries like healthcare and finance, which is heavily regulated, can have challenges dealing with distributed ledgers and decentralized systems. Another thing is interoperability. the lack of interoperability and standards across different Web3 ecosystems and platforms can hinder seamless integrations. Businesses adopting Web3 technologies need to navigate this compatibility issues, and they need to ensure smooth data exchange between different systems. All right. So the Web3 ecosystem is constantly evolving, right? And it's important to stay up to date with the latest technologies and trends to remain competitive and deliver innovative solutions. So to scale the industry to new users, we must remove the complexity and uncertainty from the typical blockchain experience. So let's take a look at Circle and how we are addressing some of these points. Circle is a global financial technology company helping money move to the speed of the internet. We are building the future of money so all of you can build the future of blockchain and internet. We already have a large number of businesses from different industries leveraging our platform today for minting, redeeming, and transacting with USDC. But there's so much more to do that. We're not just a stablecoin issuer. We want to create the platform that helps organizations run their business with digital assets on-chain. Many of you probably heard about USDC. Anyone heard about USDC before? Only three? Come on, you probably heard about USDC. Thank you. So USDC is a one-to-one backed digital dollar. Like I mentioned, it moves globally at the speed of internet, rather than along slow, disconnected legacy payment rails. Since USDC was launched in 2018, Circle has published monthly reserve attestation reports regarding the reserve balances that are backing USDC. Transparency is one of the most important things for us. And so far, USDC supported at least $30 billion worth of economic activity in 2022 and spans more than 190 countries with more than $10 trillion transacted. So we are a truly global global organization. Okay, so blockchain can be utilized in many different use cases, but probably one of the most obvious use cases is cross-border payments and remittance. And payments in general. Blockchain and stablecoins like USDC can reduce the cross-border payment, cross-border transfer cost, and also it can lower the settlement time. It can also be used for P2P payments, so users can transact dollar value with each other without relying into a bank account. And another relevant use case, probably this is really relevant for people who live in Turkey here, it can be used as a hedging against inflation in local currencies. So holding USD in the form of stable coins can help you to mitigate the FX risk of holding like a local currency like Turkish lira, where there's a high inflation and economic instability. All right, so let's dive into our tools to make it easy to start a Web3 business. Our APIs make it easy for Circle account customers to seamlessly integrate digital asset payment flows directly into their applications. You can think this as like a near instant and cost-effective way of doing payments and payouts. We can also track these payments directly within your Circle account dashboard. We recently launched cross-chain transfer protocol, which basically allows you to burn and mint native USDC. We also launched our programmable wallet solution, which seamlessly embeds Web3 wallets with a Web2-like experience in your app. Programmable wallets leverage familiar APIs and SDKs. Lastly, USDC is native across many leading blockchains, including Cosmos. And we want developers to choose native USDC when building apps across blockchain ecosystems. So to recap, putting all these together, Circle's platform, Circle account, programmable wallets, and CCTP helps businesses and devs accelerate their growth. First, let's look into Circle account briefly. So Circle provides a dashboard to easily mint and redeem our stables. as well as hold funds and manage transactions. In addition to the UI, Circle account holders can also mint and redeem through a seamless API integration. For flexibility and security, users have the ability to manage specific roles and permissions for how individuals in your business can manage these transactions. Now, let's talk about our programmable wallet solution. Just like many developers built their tools on tools and software on top of AWS, Circle provides tooling to make it easier for developers to build apps on top of blockchain. If you're a Web2 developer or if you're a Web2 builder, you can launch your project as soon as 3 to 4 weeks. And if you are familiar with Web3, you can launch your project in only 2 weeks. Okay, what are programmable wallets? So our wallets are built with MPC technology, which means you no longer need the seed phrases. All you need is a login experience that's similar to traditional applications that you use. Programmable wallets are using REST APIs and SDKs. They can be controlled by the developer, meaning developer can choose to share transaction signing responsibilities with the users. But also it can be done, it can be user controlled. So the developer can ensure that each transaction is explicitly signed by the user. Programmable wallets can be created on various blockchains. So it's not only for USDC, but it's for multiple blockchains. And it's designed for developers to tailor their wallets to the UX that best fits their application. We also have an out-of-the-box operations dashboard and tooling for day-to-day monitoring and debugging of on-chain activity. The developer console that's included in this provides a one-stop shop platform that provides the tools that needed to debug, launch, and also scale Web3 applications. There are many use cases for programmable wallets, but we can look into some examples. If you're an asset manager or a fintech or an exchange, not only you can move funds quickly and create different limits, but you can also create a large number of wallets. And these number of wallets can generate, like for the asset managers, they can generate millions of unique addresses on demand. They can receive and collect deposits from millions of customers, have callbacks to update their business of on-chain events, and also fee-optimized processing of funds for their asset workflows. If you are focusing on payments and transfers, you can move the funds very cheaply through the blockchain that you prefer. And you can also create you can use it on different use cases. For example, you can create loyalty programs. You can create closed-loop systems or token-gated experiences where you can leverage NFTs. You can control the full experience. So through one API, operation dashboard, lean and full client SDKs, you're able to deploy multiple wallet constructs into your app and power your business and use case. Developer control wallets, which means developers control access to the private keys and have the ability to manage assets on behalf of their users. In this construct, all the responsibilities and complexities of Web3 are essentially delegated to the developers. So these are securing private keys, on-chain gas fees, managing transactions, and smart contract integrations. So developers can control wallets to deliver efficient and seamless user experience. What about the user control one? So user control, the end users have full control over wallets and private keys, and only end users are allowed to initiate transactions. So this is where wallet control is given to the users. So they have full ownership of their assets, such as crypto assets or assets they've earned from loyalty reward program. These users need to be enabled to fully own their assets without being exposed to the complexities, such as primitive private key security and recovery models, out of context experience, and also the gas fees. This construct also gives users sole control over their wallets with a simple PIN code. And it also allows them to recover their wallets with easy-to-remember, user-defined security questions. These questions can be anything like, what is your favorite sports team? What was your childhood nickname? And all that. So let's look at some screenshots. With our SDKs, users can, users can select a PIN number. So we provide the SDK for user to enter a PIN. But a developer control wallet, they don't need to use the SDK as they are the ones who have control over the transactions. So there's no PIN code there. On the left, first two is the end user setting up their PIN code, and the final two screenshots. Final two screenshots are basically the user verifying a transaction after that user initiated the transaction. Now, what happens if the user forgets to PIN? Like I mentioned, it's really easy to recover your account. Basically, the user only has to answer one of their secret questions. All right. Lastly, I want to talk about our cross-chain transfer protocol briefly. So CCTP, as how we call it in short, CCTP allows for native cross-chain transfers. We believe that supporting USDC natively on a chain rather than through a bridge or wrap version is preferable, as it provides additional security, liquidity, and interoperability. Blockchains exist in silos. Back in the day, the only way to transfer or move USDC from one chain to another chain was using like a typical bridge solution. Most of the time, these bridges are lock and mint approach, but we believe there are serious drawbacks with these approaches. So I'm not going to go in all of the drawbacks, but a few important ones are, first is the security risks. Honeypots of USDC locked within a bridge smart contract can be vulnerable to exploits. Most of the bridge hacks that we've seen recently, mostly last year or earlier this year, is because of this. There's also a fragmentation issue. So multiple unofficial bridge version of USDC results in fragmented liquidity and also a really poor user experience, right? As users need to constantly figure out which form or bridge USDC is the one that they need, or which form or which bridge version of USDC is the one that application supports. Last but not least, inefficient. It's really inefficient. Bridge USDC is path dependent, so most of the time it's designed to be bridged from only one source chain to one destination chain. And in many cases, bridges can take days to facilitate the unbridging, which ties up the already fragmented liquidity. So what's our solution? Our solution to this is cross-chain transfer protocol, which is a permissionless on-chain infrastructure that facilitates USDC transfer between blockchains through a native burn and mint structure. We believe CCTP is a breakthrough in stablecoin infrastructure because it enhances the interoperability of USDC by making it natively multi-chain, all secured by the same technology that you all know and trust today from Circle. Anyone can tap into CCTP as a way to move USDC freely across supported blockchains. So how is CCTP designed? CCTP is a set of composable smart contracts paired with an off-chain attestation service. So Circle's attestation service provides an automated way to validate the authenticity of transactions. You can think this as like similar to how Circle's operations work today in the commercial Circle account. It's really easy to integrate CCTP and enable your users to move any amount of USDC to any supported ecosystem. In many cases, your app can inherit CCTP functionality from a bridge or messaging protocol platform that's already part of your stack. We work with several integration partners that already integrated CCTP into their application. So if you are using one of our partners, you would automatically have access to CCTP. One thing I'm really excited about CCTP, it allows you to stack up different use cases and leverage the strong parts of different chains. So it opens up a new world of many different use cases, and not just limited to trading, lending, payments, and more. So now developers can design simplified interfaces and automated transactions that abstract the complexity away from the users. Few example use cases, and again, it's not limited to this, but just few examples. It can be used for cross-chain swaps. It can enable users to perform really highly capital efficient swaps for native digital assets that live on distinct chains. For example, ETH for USDC through CCTP to USDC to AVAX. Or you can use it for cross-chain deposits, where users can use USDC on one chain to open up a position on an exchange in a different chain without ever even need to switch wallets or think about which chain that they're holding USDC on. And another use case idea is payments and cross-chain transfer, cross-chain purchases. It will really, we believe that it will really simplify the payments and cross-chain purchases. An example is that with one click, users will be able to utilize USDC on a different chain to buy an NFT on a totally different chain. And then they can automatically list it for sale on a different marketplace. This is extendable to any e-commerce application, and essentially it allows users to treat USDC as a chain agnostic digital dollar. And this is one of the reasons why I said we want to make the USDC as the money of blockchain, the money of internet, and CCTP is one step towards that. That's all I have, but make sure you join our Discord. We have a vibrant and growing community. If anyone wants to use the QR code. We have a global community of passionate people, enthusiasts, developers, entrepreneurs, and all that. And one thing that I also want to mention is that if you're a builder, if you're working on a project, early stage project, we have a grant program. We are providing financial, operational, technical, and marketing support to early stage projects. You can join our Discord to learn more, or you can just go to this website and learn more about it. And if you have any questions about building on Circle, any of our products or protocols, or any of our support programs, a few Circle people will be here. You'll see our t-shirts, and if you have any questions, just come and find us. And we'll have a booth outside, so make sure to stop by there. And thank you. That's all I have.